Here, we are looking at Insta360 GO 2 footage in 4K. Check your video settings right here to make sure you're seeing this in 4K. Or better, watch it on your 4K TV. Here is 4K side-by-side comparison with GoPro and Insta360 ONE R. Both of those cameras capture 4K video out of the box. As you can see, GoTo 4K video look as good, if not better, than GoPro and ONE R.
But how can I turn on the 4K capture mode with my brand new Insta360 GO 2? God, I look like a super nerd.
Good question, Keely. Well, you don't have this feature right out of the box just yet. This tutorial will teach you two techniques to upscale and up quality your GoTo 2K footage into 4K with AI. One of the techniques is also free if you have the DaVinci Resolve Studio version. We will compare the result and the practicality between the brand new Topaz Video Enhance AI 2.0 and DaVinci Resolve 17 Superscale AI. We will even upscale Insta360 ONE X2 5.7K 360 video into 8K and compare to the image quality of Qoocam 8K. This technique allows you to upscale any video, including VR video, so you don't need to invest into expensive 8K camera like this one right here, the Sony Alpha 1 I just bought.
Weird flex, but okay.
Shut up, Keely. Let's learn some AI magic and save some money together. Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Everyone is loving the Insta360 GO 2, but it is a 2K action camera. In a 4K world, this is a step backward in technology. No matter how small the camera is, if it is less than 4K, it is useless for professional videographers or content creators. No client this day will want less than 4K video, especially we have camera like the Sony A1 right here that can shoot 8K in 10-bit. In fact, no matter what camera you are going to use, you should deliver 4K videos to your clients. Video upscaling is the magic that you need to have to master if you are serious about video content creation in 2021. On the left is GoTo in 1440p and on the right is GoTo in 4K. As you can see, what you are going to learn is going to increase your video quality dramatically, even on a mobile phone or social media. And we are going to use AI to help us. First, let's talk about the well-known Topaz Video Enhance AI. The 2021 update version is amazing. It is a lot faster, fully utilize your GPU and create a stunning result, as you can see right here. Let me show you my tutorial and how to use it and some best settings. After installation, open up Video Enhance AI. It works as a standalone app and you don't need Adobe Premiere or DaVinci Resolve to run it. Drop in the GoTo footage. I would highly recommend render out GoTo footage in 1440p in Apple ProRes. This keeps the highest quality video from the camera without any extra compression. GoTo captures 80 megabits per second high data rate video. You don't want to lose any of this data in Insta360 Studio, but HEVC or H.264 will still work. If this is your first time using Topaz Video Enhance AI, I would highly recommend using their new AI model picker to pick the right AI model. Input video quality I pick low here, go to shoot progressive video, and enhance go you pick based on the video. Here I just enhance details.
so the helper suggests Artemis low quality, which is pretty good for Go 2. Go ahead and choose this model. Sizing, pick 4K UHD, which is 3840 by 2160, and check crop to fill frame. If you need to have a film-like look, you can add grain back in here. I'm gonna do my own sharpening in post, so I put the grain amount all the way down to 0. Again, I would suggest using ProRes HQ here to keep the best quality, and check keep audio. You can click preview right here to check out the final result. As you see, this AI model is really good for people. It smooths out Kitty's face and reduces unnecessary details. But it keeps the detail in the tree area, so AI is really smart. The advantage of using Topaz AI is that it usually can detect human in the scene really well and do selective denoise and sharpening, which no other software can do. Hit X is right here. Click File, Preferences, and make sure your AI processor is using your GPU. Here I use my NVIDIA Titan RTX. Max VRAM usage I keep it to medium as I also run Premiere in the background, editing while it is rendering. Increase the usage will help you render faster. Now go ahead to start processing. If you have lots of video, you can also use batch processing. That's it, very easy to use, and AI does most of the work for you.
Okay, Topaz Video Enhance AI is not free, and it is pretty pricey. But no worry, I'm going to show you a different method using DaVinci Resolve 17 Super Scale AI, also new. It does require you to have the paid version of the Resolve Studio, but it is a lot cheaper than Adobe Premiere. And if you need an affordable video software, then Resolve 17 is the sweet army knife of everything video related, including VR360 and VR180 video production. Let me show you the Super Scale result right now. Here we have the Super Scale X2 result, and here is the original result. And here is the side-by-side comparison to the Topaz Video Enhance AI 2.0. DaVinci Resolve 17 result is not as good as the Topaz, but it is free if you have the studio version. It is also extremely fast, like 10 times faster than Topaz Video Enhance. So if money or time will be an issue, Resolve Super Scale is a great alternative solution. Let me show you the workflow right now.
Open up Resolve 17 latest version, drop in the GoTo ProRes video, match the frame rate, create a timeline, uncheck Use Project Settings, and under Format, Timeline Resolution, pick Custom. You always want to double, triple, or time 4 of your source video resolution. So here we have 2560 by 1440 2K video from the Go 2. So time 2 will be 5120 by 2880, 5.2K. It is more than 4K, but it is good. Super Scale will work harder and at the end give you a better result. For Resolve Super Scale, you always want to have an extra resolution to later on downscale back to what you need. Mismatch resolution, you choose center crop with no sizing. Drop in the video and it should look like that. At this point, you should edit your video first and do color grading. Super Scale should be your last step. Let's assume you are done editing now and want to render out your 4K video. Right click and select clip attributes. Here under Super Scale, select 2x, sharpness usually I set to low and noise reduction set to low. Here is my Resolve color grading tutorial, which teaches you a better workflow to denoise and sharpen video in the color tab. So do that instead right here. Hit OK and go to render tab. In render, I usually use QuickTime DNxHR codecs and type I choose DNxHR HQX 10-bit. Check force sizing to highest quality and force debayer to highest quality, and then add to render queue and render. As you see, it is a lot faster than Topaz Video Enhance.
In Creator Up, we are all about 360 VR immersive storytelling, so we have to talk about 360 videos. Can these techniques you just learned apply to 360 videos? The answer is yes. In fact, this is the newest denoise workflow that works as well as neat video tutorial right here. When do you upscale a 360 video? Well, all the time if you are delivering your final video on Oculus Quest 2, which max out in 8K and 60 frames per second. I shoot with the Insta360 ONE X2, GoPro Max, and View XR a lot, and they are all maxed out in 5.7K in 2021. That is a low resolution for 360 video. So I use Topaz Video Enhance AI 2.0 to upscale my ONE X2 video into 8K. Let's take a look. On the left, we have the Insta360 ONE X2 in 8K with AI. And on the right, we have the Qoocam 8K, which natively shot in 8K 360. The ONE X2 is arguably better looking than Qoocam 8K. Yes, Qoocam 8K still has slightly more detail because of a bigger sensor, but AI did a great job to match a consumer camera to a prosumer level, which blow my mind. By the way, if you use the Topaz Video Enhance AI before 2021, the version 1.0, the upscale result will have a stitch line, make it unusable for 360 video production. In version 2.0, they fixed this issue. So make sure you update to the latest version of Topaz Video Enhance AI before working with 360 or 360 VR video. Here is the upscale AI model I found is the best for Insta360 ONE X2 footage right down. Thank you so much for staying till the end. Here is a bonus tip for you. Both Topaz Video AI and Resolve Super Scale has softer image compared to the original source file. Remember, I asked you to turn the denoising and the sharpening all the way down in DaVinci Resolve? Now, we are going to bring it all back with a dedicated tool. We are going to use the Boris FX Continuum. For 360 video, you will use the BCC VR sharpening under BCC VR right here. This is the best sharpening tool for immersive video that does not create a stitch lines. If you have a 10-bit media like video from the Qoocam 8K or Insta360 Titan, you cannot use the native Premiere VR sharpening, as that effect is only a bit, and if you use it, it will make your video into a bit and create banding doing color grading. That is why we use Boris FX Continuum, a 32-bit professional plugin. But for Insta360 GO 2 right here, a better one is to use the BCC Magic Sharp. It is a magic plugin that just makes your footage look great without doing anything. Apply it and you're done. I hope you learned a lot today. Now your Insta360 GO 2 is officially a 4K ready camera in your pocket. And you don't need to invest in an expensive 8K camera for 360 production. 80% of the 360 video magic happen in post-production, and that's why I designed this 360 filmmaking masterclass for you to really up your game without breaking your bank. Check this course out, link right here. If you are new here and want to learn more filmmaking magic, please consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to stay up to date. While you at it, follow me on Facebook at 360 Creator and Instagram to check out some exclusive behind the scenes and short tutorials. And I will see you in the next tutorial, all in VR.